Hello, I'm 종택수. Who came to the presentation of this paper? The paper I prepared was for students of a distance lifelong education center located in Seoul and analyzed data about learning activity conducted by learners based on learning analytics and used actual LMS data. Therefore, it can be said that the data used in this paper has a big difference in that it uses actually LMS recorded data rather than exciting self-reported questionnaire data. The purpose of this study is to analyze the effect of gender, age, and educational experience on the total score for determining completion of 16 and on the commission under 16. This study collected log data, regulated over learning start interval, total number of learning, total learning time, and personal background data. The data were collected for 1,130 learner for 15 weeks and analyzed based on learning analysis. Content 1 Introduction 2 Theoretical Background 3 Research Method 4 Conclusion. Then I will start the full-scale presentation. In the distance education environment, actuality information about the learner learning status is an important factor in determining the success or fail of learning. The reason this is because there is growing need to closely observe the learning process and provide learning status actually to learners so that each learner can reach the final learning goals. Currently, distance education generates a lot of data based on the LMS. So, if you analyze the data stored in the LMS, it can be enough education information data to project the learner learning time and learning status relevancy actually. However, most LMS do not provide instructor with tool to track and analyze all learner learning activity. So, learning analytics can be usefully approached to project learner completion. Recently, it has been attracting attention in the accepted that learner can collect and analyze learning activity data generated during the learning process on the LMS to find the regulated in the data and predict and manage the learning outcomes based on this. Previous study, the analyzed LMS data in relation to the Department of Learning Analysis include regulator of learning time interval, total learning time, number of learning connection, attendance, degree of interaction between instructor and learner, assignment of tasks, participation of discussion, detailed project of manager area, etc. Academy achievement is projected through various factor analysis. In this study, learning through comparison and analysis of actual log data and personal background data of distance learning center run based on the analysis, how each factor affect the total score. Consisted of learning analysis. Let's take a look. In the past, learning analytics in traditional approach aim to improve teaching and learning activity Slow Runner Evolution of Constantly Recently Edged Among the Tide of Runner Data have Increased and Analytical Technical for them have been developed. Learning analytics is getting more and more attention. Learning analytics is research field then apply the predictive more found in the education system to education beyond the simple technical meaning applied to education data. It provides the platform for learner to successfully complete learning or is useful as a new project tool. Provide learner self-directed learning by visual providing the result of learning activity in the learner online learning environment, enabling learner to set goal and manage process and time to reach result. Peer-reviewed research on learning analysis. In recent study related to learning analysis, LMS log data is used to analysis factor affection affecting learner learning performance or incompleteness or to focus on research that implement a system that analyzes learner learning status. In the study of Kim Yunmi, in a study by Han Donghee and Chun Byung-jun. In a study that analyzed LMS log data of students in online course or generator university, Kim Yunmi. Hwang Se-rum, Yu Ji-won, and Learning Analysis Produce. The analysis progress of learning analysis start from the data collection stage. In the stage, personal learning activity and learning data related to learning element within in LMS are collected. Next, after progressing, search a grouping of data, classification and analysis of related data. The result of provide to the learner through the dashboard or other visualized graphing means. The analysis data can also be provided to the instructor to be used in research on improving teaching method related to learning method and learning outcomes or used to take appropriate prescription and merely for the incomplete risk group of learner. Next, Azure data collect and progressing step data can be divided into static data and dynamic data. First, static data has the following characteristics. Static data has a refined form that is systematically arranged according to the scale for each clearly distinguished variable, and it is easier to combine between different databases through a relational database design. The statistics data include the characteristics of learner managed by the learning management system LMS, demographic information, age and gender and result of purely learning, number of course experience, education experience. 4. Successful analysis and prediction. It must be possible to sufficiently reflect the characteristics of learners who fail or succeed in learning, along with selection on affection algorithm in the analysis and prediction partially. The progress data analysis on a list. 다이나믹 데이터 이제 데이터 제너레이트 during the course of learning and include learner log data regularly over learning start interval total number total learning time total number of learning and learning performance data attendance achievement test total score raw data of dynamic data is usually on structured big data with no fixed form or cannot be operated on. So it cannot be analyzed in full without pre-processing and filtering. The data collected and processing stage is a process of filtering. Only the main data required through the characteristics of the data and converting it into an analytical form. Data processing and pre-processing step require a lot of time and effort. Therefore, above all, the result may vary depending on the researcher experience and theoretical tendencies and have a direct effect on the subsequent analysis and prescription stage. Next, let's look at the research question. The research question or analysis for the effect of seven variables corresponding to the independent variable on the total score of the dependent variables and the detailed research question are of follow. Research subject male student 771, 68.2%. Female student 359, 31.8%. Total 1,130. To the next technical statistics, the average and standard deviation, minimum value, maximum value, skewness, and cutoff of the total score of the dependent variable were obtained through general trend for the analysis variable and are presented in table 2. It can be seen that all the variables corresponding to the major variable form a normal distribution with a skewness of plus minus 2 or less than a cutoff plus minus 7 or less. To the next, correlation analysis. In this study, the correlation between each variable was analyzed. The regulator of the learning started interval showed a negative correlation with the total learning time, total number of learning age, education experience, and total score, but this not show any connection with the number of subject and gender. The total score was significant for all variables except for the number of courses and negative correlation, with regretted at the beginning of the learning interval was found to the positive between the remaining variable table 3. To the next, regression analysis. As a result of the regression analysis, it was found that in the log data, the total learning time and the total number of learning, excluding regret of the learning started interval, had a significant expense on the total score. Subsequently, among personal background data, age was found to have an effect. The results are shown in Table 4. Conclusion: the study is based on objective data because the research was conducted based on actual LMS data of learners using distance learning center. The result of the study were summarized of follow. First, it was found that the total learning time and total number of learning had a significant effect on the total score. In a previous study, Kim Shite, 전영시, 권성현, 한재훈 Second, among personal background data, age was found to have a significant effect of the total score. 전봉준, 임연욱, 김유리 해보 쉬운지도 In practically, in the 20, the tendency to prioritize work is observed when work and study are performed at the same time. For this reason, it can be seen that a high unfinished rate is shown in the slow in their 20. Whichever left for temporary and economic condition. And the end. Thank you.